I had a world of my own, everything would be nonsense. You see, in my world, you wouldn't say meow. You'd say, yes, Miss Alice. Oh, but you would. You'd be just like people, Diamond. And all the other animals, too.
The second star to the right shines in the night for you. To tell you that the dreams you plan really can come true.
I'm sure Dinah's not the only one confused. Listen again.
Why does the whispering wind sound like a lullaby?
That's the Peter Pan song when it was originally planned for Alice in Wonderland. Understand? Hello. I'm Catherine Beaumont, and I was the voice of Alice in 19... way back. Not only did they use my voice, but they also filmed me as reference for the animators. And right after Alice, I was doing the same things as Wendy and Peter Pan. But there's another connection between Alice and Peter Pan that I'd like to share with you.
Curiouser and curiouser.
Alice in Wonderland had more songs than any other Disney animated feature. 14, to be exact. But during the course of several years of production, dozens of songs were written that ultimately got thrown out. Except this one.
Why does the whispering wind sound
That's not me singing. That was a girl that they hired to do a demonstration record for the proposed song. Beyond the Laughing Sky was really the first song that I was supposed to sing. And of course it was about Alice, who was dreaming about a better world, more interesting than her own. And perhaps it was that the lyrics were rather reminiscent in spirit to Over the Rainbow from The Wizard of Oz, where Dorothy also wonders what lies beyond the horizon. As in Oz, it's also a little risky starting a film with a slow ballad.
I'm listening.
For our film, a different, more lively song was written, and basically it was where Alice was naming the different kinds of nonsense that would be in her world of Wonderland. And since my singing voice was, well, I was no Judy Garland. The new song was certainly easier for me.
Why, in my world, cats and rabbits would reside in fancy little houses and be dressed in shoes and hats and trousers. In a world of my own.
Now it happened that Sammy Fain, one of the composers for Alice in Wonderland, also wrote music for Peter Pan, which was in production around the same time. Now, see if you can follow this. For Peter Pan, he took his unused melody for Beyond the Laughing Sky, and instead of Bob Gilliard's words for that song, got new lyrics from the famed songwriter Sammy Kahn, who was also assigned to Peter Pan. The new song, with the music originally written for Alice in Wonderland and the new Sammy Kahn lyrics, became Second Star to the Right, heard over the main titles of Peter Pan. Got that?
The second star to the right shines with a light so red. And if it's Neverland you need, this light will lead you there.
I wonder.
Now, what would Alice in Wonderland have been like with Sammy Fain's music and Bob Hilliard's lyrics, which of course were never used? Let's look at some of the original artwork while we listen to two demos of Beyond the Laughing Sky.
My Dinah, you're wiser than wise. Oh, what your eyes can see. You're the only one who understands my curiosity. So please tell me,
magic music from beyond the laughing sky. Why can't the swallows remain? Where is the place they fly? When they go rolling by, I'm wandering about the world beyond the laughing sky.
Oh, that was lovely.